So on my first day, I had borrowed a guitar, and there, I think maybe the amp was already there, and they taught me one song, and it was horrible. I was not good at it, and I had met Al because I was an assistant manager at a record store, and he was an employee. And then he was sitting at the counter one day, and he said he was looking for a guitar player. So I said, well, I can do it. And I didn't have anything available to me at the time that was going to be useful in a live situation. So I borrowed stuff. And then I traded a drum set for an amp. And then a friend of mine took me over to his house, and he said, take your pick. And he had a broken Les Paul, which that's what I wanted to play. And he had a Strat that was fully working. So it was Nick Green. And so I said, okay, I'm going to take the Strat and somehow pay you back. And he said, don't, just take it and go. And I played that white Strat forever, until it fell apart in my hands. Somehow I passed the audition, and then it was me and Jerry and Al trying, Al and Jerry had been together with another guitar player, and then I joined, and then me and Jerry immediately became tight. Jerry Trebotic.
Yeah.
And we found a common fascination between me and Al and Jerry of cover songs that we liked as well. You know, so we started to play those. And then Al showed me some of the songs that he had written, and he, you know, Al was totally together. His dad and mom were very accommodating for all of this. You know, we played in that garage over and over and over, you know, every day.
We're in the garage at the jam, and the boys are
smoking. So I'm just trying to play as fast as I can to loosen it up, and it's just, it's sticking with me. It's just an injury.
Just a bitch.
Heavy duty fucking roll. Ready?
Yeah.
And his dad was so supportive and would drive us to shows and stuff if we didn't have a way to get there. And Alfred Lay, good guy. And his sister Amy was just a little kid, probably just starting at MiraCosta High School in Manhattan Beach, California. And, you know, she's a great talent too, so check her out, you know. But anyways, but anyways, we filled that garage full of rock music for a long time. And we started to write songs together.
Thank you.
that's why I want to get back together with them and play with them, because it was a special vibe. I think it's on the tape, you know. There's all kinds of glitches and, you know, there's, even with the glitches, you can tell that we were tight. Like him, I really did, and I think that there was a couple of times where I remember going over to the house and he had come up with a lyric or a vocal and he put it on the tape, and I went into his bedroom and he pushed play and he played it back and we listened the whole thing through, and I just sat there going, okay, all right, and he's like, is that not good? And I said, no. No, it's fine. And what I should have said to him at the time was, this is brilliant, and you're a fucking brilliant songwriter and a singer and a melody creator, and I'm happy to be playing with you. But I never said that. That was the problem, you know? It was me, you know?
This is the last practice.
Yeah.
I had gone through some shit, you know, in my life, and I had gone through some stuff with, you know, the way that I grew up and the way that I was raised, and I wasn't willing to talk about it. And so I was very closed off, and Al was a very open guy, and he expected that, rightly so, and needed that from the people around him. And Jerry was a very gruff dude. Just Jerry was just like, yeah, man, fucking, let's just play it, you know. I want those guys to know before, you know, it's too late, that I really enjoyed playing with them. And I want to do that again, if it's possible, if we can play again. And that's what we're going to try to do. And this is just us rehearsing for a gig at a concert that we are going to play at a college or something, you know. We are going to play in the quad at, you know, El Camino College down in Southern California. And it was fun playing. Every note that we played was fun, and I loved it. And when shit got weird between us all, it was just personal bullshit, mostly me. That's what happened. We'll be right back.
think about the water spoke.
Huh? Don't think about the water spoke.
I had a good gig.
So then I should have a gig. So then I said, I have to go get you.
Well, I don't know that. I don't care.
I just have to work out so I get the rest of the day off Tuesday. Let's go work in the morning.
All right. Hello, Flipchi. Tricks. Come here and lick the camera.
Whoa.
Yeah. Dog's pretty studly, man.
That's what happened. But it was fun. We had a good time. Thanks for listening.